Lord, do it again. It's in your son Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Hallelujah. If you have your Bible, you're going to turn to Acts. Amen. Glory to God, chapter 2. Amen. I think it's custom that you stand for the reading of the word. Amen. Glory to God. Acts chapter 2. Amen. If you're able, we need you to stand on your feet. Amen. Glory to God. And reverence the word of God. Amen. Glory to God. Many of us have the applications on our phone. That's fine. Amen. Glory to God. We have a Bible. Amen. We need for you all, everybody, one mind, one body, one soul, or one cord. Amen. Glory to God. To read Acts chapter 2. Hallelujah. Glory to God. I'm going to read it from the New King James Version. Amen.
Amen.
When you have it, say amen. And the word of the Lord reads as thus. When the day of Pentecost had fully come, they were all on one accord and in one place. And suddenly, touch your neighbor and say suddenly. Say suddenly. There came a sound from heaven as a rushing mighty wind. And it filled the whole house. Touch your neighbor and say, and it filled the whole house. And it filled the whole house. And it filled my house. Hallelujah. Glory to God. When they were sick, hallelujah, glory to God. Then they appeared to them, they divided in tongues as fire, and one sat upon each other. And they were all filled with the Holy Spirit, and began to speak with other tongues as the Spirit gave them utterance. Amen, glory to God. I'm going to drop on down to verse 12, hallelujah, glory to God. The word of God says, so they were all amazed.
Uh-huh.
Oh my God.
Okay.
They were all amazed and perplexed, saying to one another, whatever could this mean? Verse 13 says, others mocking said, amen, glory to God, hallelujah, glory. Others mocking saying that they are full of new wine, hallelujah. Verse 14, but Peter,
uh-huh.
My God, but Peter, hallelujah, standing up with 11, raised his voice and said to them, men of Judea, citizens of Thomasville, Georgia, amen. In this city, hallelujah, glory to God, let this be known to you and heed my words, amen, for these are not drunk as you suppose, since it is only the third hour of the day, but this is what was spoken by the prophet Joel, amen, glory to God. Touch your neighbor and say, this is what,
this is that
was spoken by the prophet Joel, amen. I'm going to talk to you tonight for a few minutes on entitled, Move Me, Holy Ghost. Amen. Yeah. Move Me, Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. I want you to pat yourself on the chest and say, Move Me, Holy Ghost. Amen. Experience. Amen. Glory to God. But how many of you all know, amen, that when you step into the house of God, amen, that should be an Azusa Street experience. Amen. Because we're talking about the Holy Ghost. Amen. Hallelujah. We're talking about the one that told Ezekiel these dry bones can live. Hallelujah. Glory to God. We're talking about the same Holy Ghost, amen, that called Lazarus out of the grave. Amen. Hallelujah. So I have a question tonight, people of God. Why don't we see signs and wonders in the church anymore?
All right.
Oh, it's quiet right there. Hallelujah. Why is it that we come to the church, amen, glory to God, and we still see blinded eyes? Hallelujah. People walk in blind, leave out blind. Hallelujah. We still see you dealing with lust and fornication, amen, glory to God. Could it be that the Holy Ghost is not moving us? Hallelujah. Into all truth, hallelujah. If it were leading God, it's just like the GPS led me here, how can we is the keeper. Hallelujah, glory to God. When you don't want to be kept, the Holy Ghost will still keep you.
Amen.
When you want to go to the club, hallelujah, and turn it up for the world, amen, glory to God. The Holy Ghost will tell you, sister, brother, you an anointed woman and man of God. Stay at home, get on your face and pray, hallelujah. The Holy Ghost will tell you when you want to slap somebody in the church to be still and know that I am God. The Holy Ghost will tell you. Especially when the game is on, they barely can come to work. Right. But I have to ask time when they pass around the bottle of wine as a Christmas gift, we accept it. It's a saint's gift. But the Holy Ghost will move. Oh, it's quiet in my life, but I don't even care. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Because we need the Holy Ghost to move. Amen. I'm tired of coming in churches and people that come in one way still leave out the same way. I want to see people change from the Holy Ghost. The Holy Ghost will cause you to love even your enemies. Hallelujah. Instead of cussing them out on Facebook. Uh-oh.
Get them out.
Instead of
asking
them on Twitter. The glory of God, the Holy Ghost will convict you to say, the Bible says I'm to love you. And I'm going to love the H-E-L-L-I-E. Amen. Glory to God. We need to get into a position in a place of prayer. Hallelujah. That's another word, cuss word in the church. Amen. All right. Just because they took it out the schools, don't mean we got to take it out the church. Amen. All right. All right. How you have a program and ain't no intercessory prayer? Hallelujah. How you have a revival and a conference and ain't no praying going on? That's because you moving me and not the Holy Ghost moving you. But when the Holy Ghost moves you, it'll convict you to say, you know, we need to get in prayer.
Yeah.
Before I grab this microphone, I need to be on my knees saying, Lord, it's me standing in the need of prayer.
Yes.
When the Holy Ghost moves you, glory to God, you won't have to be told that when the altar is called. Won't nobody have to come get you, you just make your way on up.
Yes.
Because the Holy Ghost will move you, amen?
Yes.
Many of us need a filling and a refilling. Hallelujah.
Yes.
The Bible says that there's one filling, but there's many refillings. When the last time you believed, when the last time you received the Holy Ghost?
All right.
All right.
See, it's quiet because nobody asked that question.
Hallelujah.
Because they say all you got to do is come to church and say, no, you got to have the Holy Ghost.
All right.
I'm not saying you got to speak in tongues, but you do need to have some characteristics of the one that you serve. The one that you serve. No matter who you say you call, they can't in your heart. Because he's that box of comforter, which is the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
So how can you just come to church without it? How can you fellowship without it? How can you worship without it? It's like tingling grass. The Bible says he's seeking such that would worship him in one spirit.
And
in spirit is the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
Spirit and in truth. But see, that's because we're not trained, amen, glory to God, to let the Holy Ghost lead us. We have a lot of gifts, but we have no power, which is no Holy Ghost.
Yes.
We can preach and pack the church out and raise thousands of dollars in the offering, but nobody's healed.
Come on.
Nobody's delivered.
My God.
Nobody's saved. It is not your works that's going to get you in heaven. It's going to get you to hell.
Amen.
But it's the leading of the Holy Spirit convicting you to repentance, convicting you to be in a place where God can do what? Restrict and constrain you. That's why the Bible says that he loves those. That he chases those that he loves. But if every time somebody tells you, sister so-and-so, you might need to be quiet, you get offended, and you know you're the chatterbox of the church, that's not letting the